In this video, I'll be explaining a two-stroke engine. Now, the main difference between a two-stroke engine and a four-stroke engine, which we typically have in our cars, is the four-stroke engine, is that the engine will fire once per rotation of the crankshaft, whereas in a four-stroke engine, the engine will fire once for every other rotation of the crankshaft. Now, here's how this works. In a four-stroke engine, and now here I've got labeled the direction that the piston will be moving. You'll have the intake, the piston goes down. You'll have compression, the piston will move up. You'll have combustion, the piston will move down. And each one of these, up and down of a piston, represents one rotation of the crankshaft. And then finally your exhaust, and the piston will move back up and push out the exhaust. Now in a two-stroke engine, you consolidate all of this to happen with the piston only going up and down once. So as the piston goes up, you have a compression cycle, and then right at the top, when it stopped moving, you have ignition. Now from there, the piston's going to move down, and in that step of this piston moving down, you're going to have combustion, intake, and exhaust all in one step. Now I've drawn a diagram here to help explain that. So first we'll look at the piston moving up. So you've got the gas in this chamber, and it's going to push up, the piston's going to move up, and pressurize that air-fuel-oil mixture. And then once it's right at the very top, the spark plug will ignite it, and you'll have combustion, or that's your ignition step. So that's pretty similar to a four-stroke engine. Here's where it differs. Now, notice that there's no valves here, so there's not going to be any camshafts, and there's no valves controlling the intake and exhaust. These are actually just holes which will be in this actual cylinder itself. The piston here acts as the valves. So as this piston moves down, what's going to happen is it's going to first open to the exhaust. So all this combusted air is going to go out into the exhaust. Now as it keeps moving down, it's going to be pressurizing this chamber right here. Now while this chamber is being pressurized, it's going to open up the intake. Now this intake is going to let this pressurized air, fuel, oil mixture move into the chamber. Now, so it's finally going to get down to the bottom, all the fuel has been exhausted, and now it's letting fuel in. Now it's going to take that fuel, pump it up. While it's pumping it up, compressing the air-fuel-oil mixture in this chamber right here, what's happening is this little inlet right here is going to open, and so this is where your actual air-fuel-oil mixture is coming in. So it's going to be coming in here, and then it's going to press up, ignite it, the exhaust gases are going to go out. Now the thing that you'll notice here is that the inlet and the exhaust are both going to be open at the same time. And there's several things that engineers do in order to prevent gas from escaping. And ultimately, some gas will pretty much always escape, but there are ways to reduce it. One way is loop scavenging. Here's another method where you design the exhaust that it creates pressure wave to force back in. So let's say some of our fuel has come out here and then it started to leak into the exhaust. Well, these exhaust gases come out like this and then they'll bounce back onto this wall and come back and force that small amount that's come out into the exhaust back into the chamber, and then it'll compress it and combust it. So that's one method that they use to prevent that. Now, here's another thing with a two-stroke engine. You're going to have your air and fuel around the crankcase. Now, the crankcase houses the crankshaft, and that's where the push rods are going to be rotating it, connected to the pistons. Now, in a four-stroke engine, this is closed, and you just have your engine oil in there, which is much better lubricant, and that's why four-stroke engines typically last longer. Now, in a two-stroke engine, you've got your air and your fuel mixed with the crankcase. So you're going to have to put in oil with your gasoline and so that you can lubricate these moving parts. And that's kind of a disadvantage of a two-stroke engine. And that's the main summary of how a two-stroke engine works.